हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग। आई सीमा गर्ग, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन केमिस्ट्री, एसपीसी गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज, अजमेर। टुडे वीडियो 138, इट इज फॉर बीएससी पार्ट टू, ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री पेपर टू। In continuation of aldehyde ketones name reaction, today we will discuss about some more reactions, that is Perkin reactions, Knowalgen reactions, Wittig reactions, etc. Perkin reaction. This reaction is useful for only aromatic aldehyde to obtain alpha beta unsaturated acids. See here, this benzaldehyde, when it is reacted with acetic anhydride in presence of sodium acetate, it will give us alpha beta unsaturated acid. Mechanism. The sodium salt of acid acts as a base to form anion nucleophile of anhydride by abstracting a proton. See here how it will extract proton from anhydride and it will give carbon anion, and this carbon anion when reacted with another molecule of benzaldehyde, it will give us this anion, and this on hydrolysis with acetic acid, it will give us this product, which on evolution of water molecule, it will form cinnamic acid. Alpha beta unsaturated cinnamic acid. Next reaction is Knowalgen reactions. Knowalgen reaction. This reaction is given by both aliphatic and aromatic aldehydes. In this reaction, an active methylene compound, acetoacetic ester, malonic ester, etc., condenses with an aldehyde in the presence of a base to produce alpha beta unsaturated acid. See here how it will give us this if it is aliphatic acid, it will give protonic acid. Aromatic, it will give cinnamic acid. Mechanism. First, this malonic ester base will abstract proton and it will form carbon anion. And this carbon anion, when reacted with aliphatic or aromatic aldehyde, it will form this anion, which on hydrolysis, it will give us this product. Reaction with ammonia. When formaldehyde reacted with ammonia, then hexamethylene tetramine is obtained. Its commercial name is uropropane. See here, three molecules of formaldehyde and three moles of ammonia when reacted, it will give us this uropropane, right? Apart from this formaldehyde, other aldehyde also gives nucleophilic addition product, aldehyde ammonia. See here, acetaldehyde, when reacted with ammonia, it will give acetaldehyde ammonia. And then benzaldehyde, suppose if it is reacted with ammonia, it will give us benzaldehyde ammonia, which on this removal of water, it will give aldamine or alanine, or it is known as Schiff's base. Acetone, when reacted with ammonia, gives complex ketonic amine. See here, this ketone, when it will react with ammonia, it will give us diacetone ammonia. It is a complex. Next reaction is Witte reactions. It is the most important reaction for converting carbonyl double bond into carbon-carbon double bond. It is a residue selective reaction. So carbonyl group, with the help of Witte reaction, it will give us this unsaturated carbon-carbon double bond. In this reaction, an aldehyde or ketone is treated with a phosphorus halide to afford an alkene. Triphenyl phosphine, or it is known as triphenyl phosphine, when it is reacted with alkyl halide, it will give us phosphonium salt, which on reaction with base, it may be phenyl lithium or sodium hydride. It will give this product phosphorus halide, or it is called alkylidine triphenyl phosphorane. See how it is reacted. Aldehyde, when it is reacted with phosphorus halide, it will give us alkene and triphenyl phosphorus phosphine oxide. See here, it is reacted phosphorus halide, it will form intermediate betaine, and this betaine, when it is rearranged, it will form alkene and it will give us triphenyl phosphine oxide. This reaction is a completely residue selective. Wherever it is a carbonyl group, only that carbonyl group it can be converted into the carbon-carbon double bond without interfering other groups. So this is about some important reactions of aldehyde ketones.